So let's ask, what is a matched filter in a communications system? So let's consider some data, 110. We're going to send that with a +1 voltage, a +1 voltage, and a -1 voltage. And we represent these as impulses that are going to go into our transmit filter. So we need to send a signal for a period of time, capital T, and we're going to send a positive version of it or a negative. And so the impulse response, here's one for example, might be a square wave that lasts for capital T time. So if our ST had an impulse response, if our filter here had an impulse response that looked like this, then we would be sending a square waveform for every time that we hit it with an impulse, every time we put an impulse into here. And if it's a positive impulse, we'll send a positive pulse. And if it's a negative impulse, we'll send a negative pulse. These impulses convolved with the transmit filter. In our channel, we assume we've got a gain in our channel. And in this case, we're going to consider the additive white Gaussian noise channel, where in the receiving amplifier, there's some noise, because there's always noise when you have heat in an amplifier. And so now our challenge is, in our receiver, how do we decide? We've received a waveform like this, and we have to decide, it's over a period of time, it's an analog waveform now, it's coming, we've changed from digital into an analog signal that's being sent over the channel. And how do we decide whether it was a positive waveform that we were sent or a negative? And the answer is we need to collect up all the energy between zero and capital T. So how do you collect up energy? Well, you need a filter. And the question is, what should be the impulse response of this filter? What should H of T be? And we're going to show that it should be a matched filter and say what that means. Okay, so we've got to design this impulse response here. That's our challenge. And we're going to sample the output of this filter at times T equals integer units of capital T. So T, 2T, 3T, and so on. Okay, so this, we're going to call this signal here Y of T. So we've got signals coming in, data signals, we've got noise, and we've got Y of T. We're going to sample it at these times. So let's consider when the gain equals 1, for example, gain equals 1, and let's just consider the first time slot between 0 and capital T, in this example here where we've got a positive signal coming. So in this case, Y T, when we sample it at little k equals 1, so we're sampling it at capital T time, this is going to equal, well, what's it going to equal? Well, ST has come from here because we've got a positive impulse convolved with S of T. It's gone into the channel, multiplied by the gain of 1, and then added noise and come through this filter. So it's going to be S of T convolved with H of T and evaluated at T equals capital T, plus the noise component. So the noise is coming in, so plus N of T, convolved with the receive filter and evaluated at T equals capital T. Okay, so this is our signal that's coming out here, sampled at the time capital T. This is what it is. And so more information on convolution, there's plenty of videos on our channel about convolution, as well as additive white Gaussian noise channels. Okay, so let's use the term here, YS of capital T. This is the signal component of our received voltage output here. And then there's a noise component. That's this component here plus this component here. And we can define the signal to noise ratio. And the signal to noise ratio is the power in the signal component, which is YS squared at the at that sampling time. So this is what's out of here. This here is the value that's come out here at the sampling time. It's not a waveform, it's a value, numerical value at the time little t equals capital T. So this is the value of the energy in that, is the square of the voltage. And this is a random number, this one, because this is from noise, and noise is random. So for this, we define it as the expected value of the square of that term there, because that is a random number, so we have the expected value. And what we can show, we won't show it here, but what we can show is that this signal to noise ratio is maximized when you choose this filter here to be matched to the transmit filter. And what do we mean by that? Well, when HT equals S of capital T minus little t. And so when the impulse response of the receive filter has the same shape as this filter, the same shape as the transmit filter, in this case I drew an example where it's a square, but it has where the time is reversed and it's shifted by capital T. Okay, and if that's the case, then the signal to noise ratio equals 2 divided by N naught, which is the power spectral density of the noise, times the added up energy of our signal over that period of time. This is the signal to noise ratio. As if you choose the receive filter to have this form. And this is what we mean by matched, the matched filter. So let's draw an example of that to help us understand this. So I'll draw this example that we have here. So when there's a square, which is the example we've shown. So when there's a square here as our ST, this is going to be convolved with our signal here. So we're looking at the top of this, the numerator of this here, but not squared, just the value, YST. So it's the signal convolved with, well, this is what this equals now, because HT, this is HT. In this case, it's the time-reversed version of this, so flip this over in time and then shift it by capital T. It comes to be this. It's actually, in this example, it's the same shape. It has the same shape exactly, okay, because it's time-reversed and shifted, which gives us back this. And when we convolve two squares together, we get, as you know, and again, there's videos on this if you need to be reminded of this, then the convolution of two squares is a triangle. Okay, so this is a triangle, and so this is the output here, it's the component here, YS of T, which is then going to be sampled to give this value here at capital T. And what is that? That's this point here. So if you sample this at capital T, you get that value here. And this makes sense. Why does it make sense? Well, the signal here is coming out of here, and this filter now is going to be adding up. What this says is it adds up the energy that is coming out of the channel up here. So the energy that's coming out of the channel over time gets added up until it reaches a maximum peak at the time capital T, and that is when you do the sampling. And then it dies down from the first symbol, from the first digital bit that was sent. And so here you can see clearly, because you're sampling at capital T, you're sampling at the peak time, and that's going to be very good for the signal-to-noise ratio. And as we said, it turns out it's the best. It maximizes the signal-to-noise ratio. So this choice of the filter maximizes the signal-to-noise ratio. Here's the example that makes sense. Just as an example, we extend it. Well, if we had another, like up here where we said the data was 1, 1 and 0, if the second signal is going to be coming afterwards here, so the second component here, well, what's the effect of that? That is going to be convolved with this. It's time offset. And so this will be giving you a triangle like this, which is these, obviously the output is the addition of these two triangles, but I'm just drawing the components here. And if you have a negative following, then this would be a negative waveform here, and convolved with this gives you a negative triangle, again time shifted again. So I'm drawing the three components here from the three different inputs. As I say, the overall received signal would be the addition of these three triangles. But what you can see is at the sampling times you are only getting the contribution from that symbol. So at T there's no contribution from the next symbol. At 2T the contribution from the symbol before and the symbol after is zero. And all you are doing is sampling from the second symbol that was transmitted. Likewise for the third symbol. So this shows you an example of why it is that the signal-to-noise ratio might be maximized. It's not a proof, but it's an example of showing you that the signal-to-noise ratio, it builds up the energy and then it samples. And it samples at the peak. And that this is clearly going to be a good thing to do for the signal-to-noise ratio. But again, that's why it's matched, because the impulse response of the receive filter is matched to the shape that you chose for the transmit filter. That's why it's matched. Okay, so don't forget to like this video. It helps others to find the video, and subscribe to the channel for many more videos.